life at playtime, story time. Follow your dreams at playtime, story time.
Hello, boys and girls. My name is Victoria, and I'd like you to think of me as your fairy godmother storyteller. And today I have an amazing story to tell you. This is an old tale that's been retold many times, and it's called The Clown of God. The Clown of God takes place many years ago in a place called Sorrento. Sorrento is in Italy. Once upon a time, there lived a small boy named Giovanni. He had no mother and no father. He dressed in rags and begged his bread in doorways. But he was happy, and he could do something wonderful. Crowds would gather to watch, and when Giovanni had finished, they would buy bread and fruits from Signor Battista. Then Signor Battista's wife would give Giovanni a bowl of hot soup. It was a very good arrangement for both of them. One day, a troupe of traveling players came to town, and Giovanni watched as Arlecchino and Colombina in their beautiful clothes danced and sang. "Oh," Giovanni said to himself, "this is the life for me." He could juggle. Every day he would go to Signor Battista's fruit and vegetable stand and juggle. He would juggle lemons, he would juggle oranges, apples, eggplants, and even zucchini. Crowds would gather to watch, and when Giovanni had finished, they would buy from Signor Battista. Then Signor Battista's wife would give Giovanni a bowl of soup and some bread. It was a very good arrangement.
One day, a troupe of traveling players came to town, and Giovanni watched as Arlecchino and Colombina, in their beautiful clothes, danced and sang. "Oh," said Giovanni to himself, "that's the life for me." So when the play was over, Giovanni went and spoke to the maestro.
"Oh, no," said the maestro, "I have no need for a ragamuffin. Go beg your bread somewhere else."
But I could be very helpful," pleaded Giovanni. "I could help unpack and pack up. I could take care of the donkey." "And maestro," said Giovanni, "I can juggle."
When he finished juggling, maestro said, "Not the bad. With a bit more training and practice, all right, but no money. A place to sleep, the companionship of the finest players in all of Italy, and a bowl of noodles. That's all." "Grazie, signor," said Giovanni. "Go get your things. We leave in 1 hour, said the maestro.
So Giovanni said goodbye to Signor Battista and became a traveling player in the maestro's troupe. Not long after, the maestro gave him a costume, and Giovanni juggled for the crowds. He would put on his clown face, step out of the curtain, and before the play began, bow, open his colorful bag, roll out a carpet, and begin. He would juggle sticks. He would juggle plates. He would balance the plates on the sticks and twirl and juggle them. He would juggle clubs, rings, and burning torches. Finally, he would toss a red ball and an orange ball, then a yellow ball, a green, blue, and violet ball, until he looked like he was juggling the rainbow. "And now for the sun in the heavens," he would cry. Still juggling, he would pick up a shining golden ball and toss it even higher and faster, and the crowds would cheer and cheer. Giovanni became very famous. And it wasn't long before he said goodbye to the troupe and set off on his own. Up and down Italy he traveled, and although his costume became more and more beautiful, he always kept the face of a clown. Once he juggled for a duke, for a prince,
and it was always the same. First the sticks, then the plates, then the clubs, then the rings, then the burning torches, and finally the rainbow of colorful balls. And now for the sun in the heavens, he would shout, and the golden ball would fly higher and higher, and the crowds would laugh and clap and cheer. One day, between two towns, Giovanni was sitting in the shade, eating his lunch of bread and cheese. Two little brothers came down the road.
"Will you share your food with us, Gudda Clown?" they asked. "For the love of God and the blessing of the brother Francisco."
"Sit down, good fellows," Giovanni said. "There is more than enough." And the three men ate. The two little brothers told Giovanni how they went from town to town, begging their food, spreading the joy of God.
"Our founder, Brother Franciscus, says that everything sings of the glory of God."
"Why, even your juggling," said one of the brothers.
"Oh, that's well and good for men like you, but I only juggle to make people laugh and applaud," Giovanni said.
"It's the same thing," the brother said.
"If you give happiness to people, you give glory to God as well."
"If you say so," said Giovanni, laughing. "Now I must be off to the next town. Arrivederci, good brothers, and good luck."
And wherever Giovanni went, the air was filled with flying sticks and plates, his clubs and rings and torches, always his rainbow of balls and the sun of heavens.
And whenever Giovanni went, the faces of the crowds would be all smiles, and the sound of laughter and cheers rang through the towns every time he juggled. But years passed. Giovanni grew old, and times became hard. People no longer stopped to watch.
"It's only that silly old clown who juggles things. We've seen him before," they'd say.
Giovanni was sad, but he still juggled until one day he dropped the sun in the heavens and the rainbow of balls came crashing down and the crowd stood and jeered and laughed and pointed, but not from joy. They did not like what he was doing. Then they did a terrible thing. They threw vegetables and stones at Giovanni so that he had to run away for his life. Beside a stream, Giovanni took off his clown face forever. He put his sticks and his plates, his clubs and his rings and colored ball. He put his costume away and he gave up juggling. What little money he had was soon gone, and his clothes became rags, and he begged his bread and slept in doorways as he did like when he was a child. "It's time to go home," the old man said wearily, and he headed back to Sorrento. It was cold that night when he finally arrived. The wind blew hard and an icy rain was falling. Up ahead loomed the monastery church of the Little Brothers. The windows were dark. Wet and cold, Giovanni crept inside and fell in a heap in a corner. Soon he was asleep. It was the music that woke him up. The church was blazing with candlelight and filled with people singing Gloria, Gloria. Giovanni could scarcely believe his eyes. So much beauty. A long procession of brothers, sisters, townspeople, priests, all carrying beautiful gifts, was winding its way through the church. And they placed their gifts in front of a statue. It was of the lady and her child. "What is all this?" asked old Giovanni to someone standing near.
"Why, old man, it's the birthday of the Holy Child," the woman said. "It's the procession of gifts."
Giovanni watched with amazement until the singing was over. Then the church emptied of all the people, and except for the bright candles surrounding the lady and the child, Giovanni moved closer
The child in the lady's arms seemed so serious and so stern.
"Oh, lady," said Giovanni, "I wish I had something to offer you like the other people, too. Your child seems so sad, even with all these beautiful gifts. But wait, I used to make people smile." Giovanni opened his bag, shook out his old costume, put on his clown face, bowed, rolled out the bag, and began to juggle. First the sticks, then the plates. Then he twirled the plates on the sticks, and then the clubs and the rings. And the brother Saxton, who was coming in to lock the door, saw Giovanni juggling.
"Father, master," he cried, rushing off to get the priest. "A sacrilege, come quickly."
But Giovanni did not notice or hear him. "And now," said Giovanni, smiling at the face, "first the red ball, then the orange, now the yellow, then the green, then the violet, then the blue." Around, there was the rainbow. And finally, Giovanni said, "The sun in the heavens!" The gold blue flew up and around, higher and higher. Giovanni had never juggled so well in his whole life. Faster and higher and faster, a blaze of color filled the air. It was magnificent. Giovanni's heart was pounding. "For you, sweet child, for you," he cried. Then suddenly, his old heart stopped and Giovanni fell to the floor. The priest and Brother Sexton came running. Stooping over old Giovanni, the priest said, "Why, the poor clown is dead. May his soul rest in peace." But when the Brother Sexton backed away, and with his mouth wide open, he stared at the statue and at the lady and her holy child. "Oh, father," he said, pointing, "father, look." The child was holding something and smiling. In his hand was the golden ball. And that is the story of the Clown of God.